Innovate is brought to you by
Visit us at St. Lawrence University near Miracle Center Cathedral in Rubaga or call 0414-693-122 or 0414-270-082. St. Lawrence University for ICT and entrepreneurship.
Welcome back from that short break. Of course, you're still watching Innovate here on Urban TV. Now, after widely advertising and receiving over 400 applications to the Youth Spark Innovation Grant, YC Grant Call, a rigorous judging process, and selection at the East African Resilience Lab awarded a total of 17 innovator teams as its third cohort of awardees. This grant call was targeting students within the RAN partner universities, and the award ceremony held at the Makerere University School of Public Health Resilient African Network RAN Innovation Lab was officiated by Professor Mondo Kagonyera, Makerere University's former chancellor, flanked by Professor Charles Ibinjira, Principal Makerere University College of Health Sciences, and Professor William Bazeo, the Dean Makerere University School of Public Health and RAN Chief of Party Lab Director. Also in attendance were some parents, guardians and relatives to the innovators to be awarded. Professor Mondo Kagonyera urged the young innovators to always work hard, saying that people work harder and longer hours in order to reap big in the developed world.
One of the major problems we Africans have is the lack of confidence in ourselves. You haven't been preached to about our inferiority to the other races of the world. But for us, when we grew up, that was literally the mantra of the colonials, that you Africans were inferior to other peoples of the world. So, when I see these young men and women concentrating on what they are convinced they are capable of doing, and they make their chief, who is the judge, she went, and they make these achievements. Why wouldn't I come here and join you in celebrating this occasion?
Professor Charles Ibinjira, the Principal Makerere University College of Health Sciences, in his remarks, noted that Innovators Grants Award is seed support, and that they should not eat the seed, but rather eat the leaves and develop their innovations for the market to address communities' most pressing challenges.
I want to encourage you to use this money for that purpose. You know, in Uganda, people get money, get loans for doing business, and they go and marry other wives instead of. So don't be like that.
All big things start small. Inspiration from one of the wives, Irene Kitui, who also shared with the young innovators that learning never ends.
So I'm very happy that we have 11, and I will be grateful next time to be invited to say we are going to award, we are moving from level 1, and this is the team that has moved to level 2. Don't be like the gentleman in the Bible who was given money and kept under. And when Jesus came back, he said, me, I protected the money. The money they are giving you is not to be kept under, it's given to you to make better and more innovations that are going to make a difference in society.
The host, Professor William Bazeo, shared with the awards attendees that each innovator at RAN would conduct a community needs assessment in order to innovate as per community needs, that at all time, innovators must remain relevant to the needs in the communities.
This is not material, but the money, and we must clearly say this is the USA people's taxes and their money. They are funding the Ugandans and people around, because you may say that RAN, Makerere gave. No, Makerere has not given. It is cut off.
The IARA lab set aside up to a tune of US$80,000 only to support 17 innovator teams, each receiving a maximum of US$5,000 for the initial 6 months incubation period. We spoke to some of the awardees, and they gave us an insight into their innovations.
BVKit is a self-test application that works with hardware that helps women monitor their reproductive health at home, so they don't have to wait until they are infections or illnesses worsen to go and seek medical attention.
Fruticycle is a product that helps small-scale farmers to distribute their produce, vegetables, fruits, so that it can reach the market when it's still fresh and can earn more money.
The projects awarded include Fruit Cycle, Biomass Dryer, BV Kit, Wekebere, Light Bulb, Eco Cold Room, Imusawo, Pedo Water Tap from Uganda, Self-Regulating Irrigation Systems, Moss Fields Irrigation Pumps from Tanzania, E-Health for Refugees and Entrepreneurship Clubs in Secondary Schools from Rwanda, and Totonga from DRC. The International Health Sciences University IHSU Awards Gala Night was held recently and was meant to recognize exceptional students in the ICT Health Leadership Program, as well as launch its Lift 256 incubation program. Many health applications were pitched that same day. Our cameras were there and we bring you the whole event as it unveiled. The Awards Gala Dinner's main aim is a showcase event for IHSU's postgraduate certificate in applied ICT and leadership. Four projects were presented to funders who selected a project to invest in over a period of 6 months to 1 year, and these were the Health Data Harvester, Data Aggregator, the Teleconsult Platform and the ICU Communicator. According to the consultant course director, he explains the values of the course and gives the intentions of implementing skills that will sell them out. Adding to that, the winners got $10,000 and others will be given an offer to also see their projects work out. He also gives their future plans about the outstanding project. The winning team shared with us their experience about the process, how they felt about their award and what their plans are now that their application was considered outstanding.
We came up with ICU Communicator, an application that will help us communicate between the few intensivists in the country to cover all the nine ICUs in the country.
We are grateful because we put in a lot of work and we want to help these intensivists reach many patients, because we believe the numbers of patients in the ICUs are increasing, including mothers who have just given birth, they end up in the ICU. So we believe this is going to help many patients who will need these services in the ICU.
Our plan is to move the project to the next level, that is further developing it, including a lot of other expertise on ground. Then we have the program implemented on ground.
Other innovators were also given offers for their projects, and they explained how they came up with their applications and how they're going to implement them.
Our app is called the Health Data Harvester. We came up with the Health Data Harvester when we went to Mengo Hospital and engaged with their community outreach team, and they identified a number of problems they face. So we came up with an application that's going to digitize the data collection process in the field.
Well, we target different organizations that really deal with data collection besides hospitals, but just because we are ICT health students, we felt because of the big and huge gap in the health sector, it would be of more use to the health sector for now. But any organization that is interested into data collection is a target to us.
We felt like we are really having impact. We are saving a lot. We're saving the environment. We are saving paper wastage. And we really felt like this is a very important part of this economy.
The event ended with the close remarks from the Vice Chancellor of IHSU, who was also excited, especially with the students who won, and she gave advice to the youth and encouraged more to join the university.
I'm so thrilled, particularly because the student who won has been there from the very beginning of the university. As a bachelor's degree student and has been able to advance his career to be able to get to this moment.
In November 2014, IHSU, with support from Youth with a Mission, started a training program, the Postgraduate Certificate in Applied ICT and Leadership. The purpose-built program was designed to respond to unemployment challenges of our graduates. The program specifically focuses on learner-based approach, influencing three critical areas: the mindset, skill set, and tool set. The 6 months full-time training program empowers the learners prepare for the workplace by exposing them to workplace best practices and tools. And now, realigning the program to wider industry needs will commence in August 2016. That was all we had time for this week on our technology show. But of course, with technology, every single day is a new day. We bring you great things and new creations here on Innovate. Keep following us on Twitter using the hashtag UrbanInnovate and my personal handle at Kembenda, as well as liking our Facebook page Innovate on Urban TV. I've been your host, Brenda Kembabazi. Keep watching Urban TV.
Innovate was sponsored by...
Visit us at St. Lawrence University near Miracle Center Cathedral in Rubaga, or call 0414-693-122 or 0414-270-082. St. Lawrence University for ICT and entrepreneurship.